Good afternoon and welcome to Copper Jewelry Making with Nicole. Today we'll be making a copper link bracelet. But before we get started, here's a fun fact. The coronavirus lives on most surfaces for up to 72 hours, but for some reason it only lives on copper for 4 to 5 hours. That's just something I figured people would be interested in that like to wear copper jewelry. Okay, in the background, we're listening to the late, great Ellis Marcellus, father of Wynton and Bradford Marcellus. We recently lost Ellis Marcellus to the corona-related illnesses. So rest in peace, Ellis Marcellus. First off, let's go over some of the tools we'll be using today. We will need a ruler, a round nose plier, a bell plier, a chain nose plier, and heavy duty wire cutters. Most of these tools you should already have in your toolbox at home, but if you don't, you just gotta improvise and use what you have. Okay, today we'll be using 14 gauge copper wire. If you don't have 14 gauge, you can use 12 gauge or 16 gauge as a substitute. Okay, let's start with the jump ring connectors. Each jump ring connector takes approximately 4 inches of wire. Here's your 4 inches of wire. Here's your jump ring connector. Okay, let's start with the jump ring connectors. All right, to make your jump ring connectors, you want to use the middle section of your bell pliers. Put the tip of the wire into the bell plier and turn like this. As you're turning the wire, make sure that your hand never goes like this. That could mess your wrist up. You just want to open, turn, open, turn, open, turn. Keep turning till you get all the way to the end. Take the copper off of the bell pliers. And now we're ready to cut our bell pliers. To get a nice even cut when you're cutting your jump ring, you want to line your wire cutters right up to the edge of the jump ring and cut. You should get an even jump ring every time. Let's go on and cut them off. Okay, the next thing we'll be making are our link connectors. This is the link connector. This is what we're gonna make our bracelet out of. Each link connector is 4 inches long. You wanna grab that 4-inch piece, put a turn on one end, and put a turn on another end. After you get your two turns made, you wanna go on and slide it back in that first turn and turn it one more time. Then it's a good idea to switch to your chain nose pliers to finish it up. And there you have one of your link connectors. I went on and made a few to show you how to put them together. So you want to take one of your link connectors, take one of your jump rings, open your jump ring. Remember, when you're opening your jump rings, to use your tools. Never use your hands because you'll mess your hands up. Open them from front to back. Never pull them apart because you'll mess up the shape of the jump ring. Put one end of the jump ring into one of the link connectors. Put the other end in. Then you want to close it back. Grab another jump ring. Open it up. Close it back. One thing you want to remember is to make sure your links are facing the same way. Don't put one link that way and one this way. You want them all facing the same way. Let's go on and connect a few more. This is also a good way to take your mind off of the coronavirus pandemic that has us all in the house. Well, most of us are all in the house. That's the only way to slow it down. Keep that in mind. Okay, now we have a few of our link connectors. Let's go on to one of our ending latches. This will be the latch on the left. To make this latch, you want approximately 3 inches of wire, 14 gauge, but like I said, you can use 16 or 12 if you don't have 14. You want to put one turn on one end of the wire. You want both turns going inward. Now we're going to switch to our bell pliers. And we want to push both ends down so they meet. Latch for the left side of the bracelet. Now we're going to go to the latch for the right side of the bracelet. For this latch, you're going to need approximately 5 inches of wire. You want to take your round nose pliers and try to get it right in the center. I always try to eyeball it, but I usually get it wrong. I'm a little off, but we're going to keep going. Now we want to take our chain nose pliers, press it in at the top to get rid of that space. If you get it uneven at the bottom like I did, just cut one little side of it off. Put one turn on this end. And one turn on this end. Try to bring them back in a little tighter after you get the two turns. And it takes practice, but practice makes perfect. You want to grab the wire in the middle and press it down. That part takes a bit of strength, but we need to be getting our joints moving, hands working. And you have the other latch on the other side. While we still have a little time left, I'll show you how to attach one of the links. Your tools do the work. Ellis Marcellus sounds pretty good. I never knew about him. Just always knew about Winton and Bradford. I'm not sure why my hands are shaking so much, but it's probably because this is a little nerve-wracking, but And now we're gonna close this jump ring back up. And there you have the latch on one end. Now I'll show you how to attach this part on the other end. You want your, this is the full length of the bracelet. I use 15 links, but it really depends on the size of your wrist. You might want to make a few more or a few less, depends on what size your wrist is. The bracelet wouldn't be this long. I'm gonna just show you how to attach the latch, so you'll know how to do that part and be able to make your own bracelet to wear during this corona epidemic. It's a good idea to go on and make your jump rings. I used about 32, but like I said, it depends on the size of your wrist, how many you would need. There you have it. Thanks for tuning in. I'll see you next time.